As we remember them, we recognize that many of us suffer from tragedy fatigue, don't we? We are tired of tragedy. And sometimes what happens when you are tragedy fatigued is that you either stop reading a newspaper or you turn off the television because you don't want to hear any more bad news. It also can cause us to be inured to the pain of other people. And we stop feeling because it's too much to feel. But I want to invite you tonight, even if you have tragedy fatigue, never to get compassion fatigue. Compassion is the ability to feel with other people. And if we're going to make of this old world a new world, we're going to have to always be able to feel with others, aren't we? Because every person who dies is somebody's everything. Every person who dies leaves behind a circle of connection of broken hearts. And in our community, we say hatred and bigotry is not going to be in our
towns. Well, so eloquently stated earlier was this notion of fatigue and being tired, sick and tired, being sick and tired, really suffering time and again and hearing these tragedies over the course of my lifetime, the harassment and such. And what I was discussing with my good friend was that, you know, this fatigue didn't prevent me from being here. It kind of inspired me to want to see what's going on. And part of the conversation that I feel is missing is this notion of due process and our rule of law and the double standard that's so readily applied to so many of us.
Experience that unless you have children of color, you cannot understand.
When I hear people talk about those deaths that happened in other states, it reminded me that we had a situation here in South Orange in the 1960s where a teenager was shot in the back by a police officer. But we got through it as a community. We came together. That incident pointed out many things to the community, that there was not fairness in housing, and a housing petition was subsequently circulated. We've always gotten through it, and we've gotten better. And I gotta tell you, when I went to Columbia High School, out of a school of 1,500, there were only 55 people of color there. And I never had a black teacher in my entire life. But you know what? It's different now. We're all together, and we should celebrate.
If I'm black, and I know something might happen, and 97% of the time you're gonna get off for killing somebody, you know, then where's the change there? You know, it starts, I feel like it starts with voting and legislation. You gotta vote people of like mind, power. That's the only way you're gonna get change. You're not gonna get change by not doing it for them. So I feel like the young people, the young people together, it's a nice movement. I feel like we can come together. I don't know if we gotta do emails, information, come together. Whenever somebody's voting in or learn more about this, and then stick to it and then help each other out. Because I feel like that's the only way we're going to change what's going on right now.
Thank you.